movable type and the Gutenberg's press. Made the world smaller, improved it, I guess. Same with
the original Studebaker AM radio. These things are kind of neat. They're two-piece. And I put the stand on there so we can actually tilt it down and watch the face of it. But you got a 6x9 built in it, DVC, stereo, plus you have two more channels that you can use and a pre-out to add a sub. The little radio is fully loaded. I think it's around 1953, but it is going in a truck. Studebaker truck, which is real neat. Anyhow, we polished everything up. I still got a few odd ends of dirt I got to clean off right there. But we polished it up, went all the way through it, and we've done a full Aurora Design conversion. It's got AM and FM stereo, auxiliary in, which is automatic. This is your port you'll get. It has USB. And a thumb drive comes with it. This will charge your phone, your devices, play thumb drives, auxiliary in right above there, which comes with a male-to-male cord, and we'll demonstrate that. Push-button operator, you can hide that wherever you want to, underneath the lip of the dash or in an ashtray or whatever. And Bluetooth, hand-free phone calls, voice command. It has voice ID and will scan stations for you, which is real cool. You got a little operating LED right up here, which is stereo, and over here is an operating LED. It changes multiple colors depending on what the radio is doing. And you're on FM right now, so anytime you want to know where you're at on FM, you take this little button and push it one time.
FM 89.5.
Called Voice ID. All your push buttons still work. Presets and all. Always. And we have a toner switch in this, and usually I change them out on a full conversion, but don't have any to fit this one. So we've got a toner switch. I'm going to show you how that works. It makes it kind of complicated, but once you get it set up, everything works great. This little stand that I've got comes off, and it mounts in with the screws there and the speaker. You got kind of a gasket here. These are my knobs. I did have one here that I could use because this toner control or toner switch control is kind of a funny knob, and what we've done over here, it had a speaker select. So we actually use the speaker select for AM and FM. So if you want to go to AM radio, just flip the switch.
With no closing call.
AM
it's
radio.
Personal seller.
AM 650.
257
FM. And that's the way that works. That's pretty neat. Of course, you dial and everything still works like it always did. And it will kick butt. It sounds good. That's my favorite station there. Okay, we're going to go right through it. Auxiliary in, we're going to do that first. That's AM and FM stereo. Auxiliary in, you'll get a male-to-male cord. You can plug it in here. This little piece I had to have for new phones. You find them on eBay if you want to plug your phone into it. I don't know why you got Bluetooth. But anyhow, I'll show you how it works. You just plug in any device you want. Satellite radio, CD changer, XM radio, all kind of stuff. Bring your device up and just hit play. So the little light up here has gone to green. That tells you you're on auxiliary in. Anytime you want to go back to radio, just take that device and turn it off. In 20 seconds, if you don't touch the radio, it'll automatically change back by itself. You don't even have to unplug it like I did. Or if you want to go quicker, just turn it off and back on like you... Well, yeah, turn it off and back on. You don't have to mess with that. It'll shorten that 20 seconds down. Automatically switch back. Now your toner switch is You want to change your toner. This is the toner switch. Take it clockwise all the way down. Turn your radio up. Now this is your toner. Bass, treble. When you're done, flip it back up.
Volume hold.
She'll hold it. Turn it down and then regain your volume. Now, you wanted two more channels, so you're going to be able to, you want to know how to fade. And fading, because that way you want to operate your speakers. I don't know where you're going to put them, behind the seat or in the kick panels, but you want to be able to hear them and this one. So here's how you work your fader. Flip your switch all the way down. Toner. Take your knob and crank it clockwise twice. One, two.
Fader adjust.
Now you're in fader. Take your knob. There's your ears. There's this speaker. That little pop you're hearing means that's dead center of that pot. There's your front speaker. There's the back. Let's... Alright, we're gonna stop and let her set it.
Fader set.
Now set your treble. Bass, set your treble where you want it. Flip it
volume
back.
Hold.
Take your volume down, right back up. I don't wanna drag you down. You got loudness, EQ, and crossover built in this. If you want to use it, all that's in your instructions. I'm not going to try to go into it. Try to keep the videos a little bit shorter. But it will work. I've already done it. All right. We're going to pair our Bluetooth up. There's two ways of doing it. Bring your phone up to settings. Let's go that way. You go to Bluetooth. And you can turn the volume up twice. One, two. Or you can hold this push button down. You're going to pair your phone up. Now it will take multiple devices, it'll always pick number one. Let's do it with the bike, well let's do it with the push button.
Fader adjust.
That ain't what I want.
Fader set.
Alright, here we go. Hold it down.
Bluetooth ready to pair.
Show it up on her phone, all you gotta do is tap on it. She'll tell you when it's done.
Pairing completed. Bluetooth connected.
Alright, now we'll connect it up. You have a mic that you can run anywhere you want to. It's got plenty of lead. I just got it stuck right here. And we're going to do a voice command. You can hold this button back and down again and bring your phone up or turn the volume up twice. Like that. Play music. On the music on my phone. Now if you want to change your songs, you can go once to advance, twice to back up a repeat, or you can take your tune and go up, back. It works your phone for you. Now it's designed so you don't have this in your hand. So a phone call comes in, she's going to come on and say incoming call. Turn that up one click or push that one time, answer your call. When you're done, just let it hang up on its own. I can even do it with the push buttons. Now what we're going to do, we're going to run a little test. We're going to turn the radio off. And make sure it finds your phone after you do the initial pair up. We're going to turn it back on and go right back to where we had it going. And that's basically, if you're screaming music all the time, you get out of your truck. When you get back in, you won't go right back to where you left without having to do a bunch of stuff. And that's what it does. Turn it on, radio.
Bluetooth connected.
Right back to where we left it. Voice command. Stop music.
at 31.
Right back to radio.
Spirit of Oaks is the rock project of songwriter and producer.
Fader adjust.
It is the 7th Strand of Oaks album in
Fader set.
How high?
There's another way to do your fader by using the button.
Number
flip your switch.
This week.
All the way down.
The list.
Hi, this is Nick Forster.
1, 2.
This week in Eat.
Fader adjust.
Back to your knob.
1996 season. With musical
this
performances by Joan Armatrading, Taj Mahal, Sweet Honey in the Rock, Tuck and Patty, Leo Kottke, and more.
That's let her set it.
Fader set.
And as for
set your trouble.
Sunday nights at 9 p.m.
Bass,
on 89.
Back.
Volume hold.
This is the list, the Americana Chart Show and WMOT Roots Radio. I'm your host.
Always remember, after you fool with this, using a toner switch, take your volume back down if she says volume hold, take it back down and regain your volume.
Of course, Boy Golden and Trey. And
now we're going to do a USB port.
We're our guests this week on Finally.
You'll get one of these with the music on it, the video,
Boy Golden from Church of
and there's some manuals on there and stuff, even though I give you paper manuals. Take it, plug it in, go straight to it, because you can hide that. Same way with your USB as you did with your phone. Once, twice to back up a repeat. Depends on how long he's in the song, see? Now, if you got this head, you ain't got to take a stick out unless you want to charge something or put another thumb drive in. You can put it in pause basically by this or this. We went up on volume for Bluetooth. Let's go down. 1, 2. Put it in pause, right back to radio. Cycle back around. You can also do it with the push button. I'm going to show you how to do that. Down twice, right back to the thumb drive. 1 second. Pause, right back to radio. Right back to thumb drive. Now I'm gonna make the camera go kind of crazy. A lot of wiring in these things. Whoop! Told you I was gonna make it go crazy. Let's get it back on the stand so I can control it. There we go. Your original. I'm going to say 53, but it's a Studebaker radio, and we're going to put it in a truck with the full Aurora Design in it. And it cleaned up, it looks nice, everything's polished, and I appreciate you letting me do it for you. Thank you.